Thank you very much. It was a two very interesting presentations. One on the connectivity part, and the second one is on looking at Kerala as a manufacturing base. On the connectivity part, it is an interesting proposition. Like I mentioned earlier, the revenue model for KPhone, in terms of how do you look at constantly upgrading to ensure that the obsolescence is not happening, is something which is going to be very important. The other one is we will need to have a clear mandate by which the TSPs do not exploit the situation, because government will be giving the bandwidth at a very reasonable pricing, because the TSPs will, the expectation the TSPs will give it free or at a very low cost. So there will need to be very clear norms in getting that done. And that is the important thing which is there. The most important thing on this is that unless the revenue model is clear and the money coming in into the company which is running KPhone is not only sustainable, but also ensures that you can move with the times in terms of continuous investment without depending on funding from government or otherwise, is going to be what I would believe one of the most important things on that part of it. Coming to the manufacturing part for Kerala, I think there is one thing which we will need to definitely look at. And in that, we need to really define clearly as a policy the role of the public sector. What will the public sector do? What is more important to say what the public sector will not do? Okay. Then we talk about the joint sector, where the public sector and private sector coming together. There again, what they will do, what they will not do. And then we come to the private sector to say what is expected from them. The reason I'm telling this is that if you really look at it, you know, you find that a lot of times public sector companies end up competing with the private sector in the state or from outside the state. And that actually creates an issue by which the private sector or the joint sector is actually impacted. If you look at the case of Coconix itself, in the case of Coconix, I think KSIDC, Keltron, UST and a company from Bangalore are the partners in that. But in that, what happened was in the first major tender itself, you had the public sector competing with the joint sector. So you had partners competing with each other. And the problem there was that the product which came in from the through the public sector was not manufactured in the state. So there needs to be a clear policy of how are we going to support companies who set up manufacturing units in the state. And that is something which is going to be very important. How will government consolidate its business to support that? So that is another important thing which is there. I'll come to another one, which I think is very, very important, because there's a lot of focus which we have on startups, both on the IT side and on the other sectors. The startups in Kerala, you find over a period of time, tend to move out of the state because they believe that there is no ecosystem. And I'm happy that Hemlata talked about the ecosystem need coming up. So I will just give an example. It is not, and I wouldn't want to compare with another city in India, but I would look at a place like China, where you see a lot of small companies coming up. The thing there is a company out of Shanghai, whom I visited 2 years ago. That company is able to prepare a design for a product. And that product prototype is ready within a day, not in Shanghai, but the manufacturing is happening in Shenzhen. But there are companies there who will convert this design within a day into a prototype. For us here, anywhere in the country, ultimately, the prototype comes from China, many a time. If it is to be in India, we have to ensure that we only use certain components. We don't have the facility for a lot of changes that are there. So that is something which we need to look at in terms of how do we create that ecosystem? How do we support that ecosystem for things? The other one which was mentioned by Hemlata was the need for testing. Very correct. It is required. Certain things which... but we have a big advantage that we have the electronic regional test laboratory in Trivandrum. So I think what is important is to try to network the central government institutions, the state government institutions and public sector, look at the some of the university departments do good work, the startup system, how do we get all of them together and then say, look, this is what the state has and this is what the state lacks today. So that is something which I think would be very important to do as we prepare for the knowledge economy. And I'm just focusing on just the two areas that were presented today. There could be others on the other area, but so that is something which is very, very important to see how do we do that. Now, there needs to be a big impetus for the startups in this area. And I see Balagopal on the call, and you know, the kind of manufacturing which they were able to do, the quality of the product which came out of the originally Penpol and now the Thermo Penpol company was of international quality. So how are we as a state going to support that? Is we have to look at how do we support them to get out of the orbit. The orbit that we work in today is within our state. Okay, the larger orbit is within our country. And the third orbit is globally. How do we support companies who operate in Kerala to get out of the state orbit to cater to the national level? And how do we then get out of that orbit for this company to be competitive internationally? You must remember that tariffs and all are different, completely gone. So a product being manufactured here, if it is not as good, or if it is not commercially competitive, you're going to find that getting that product sold is going to be difficult. So you cannot anymore be manufacturing for Kerala or the Kerala government. You have to be developing products which are manufactured for the world. And for that, the ecosystem is very important. And I will just conclude. I've reached about 7 minutes. I'll conclude by saying that the most important thing is the ease of doing business. Any manufacturer coming in needs to know that I will not be stopped by a panchayat member who doesn't want the facility to be there. I will not get stopped by some bureaucrat who is going to say no, or I didn't look after that person well. So we need to have a very transparent system. I know the government now has one which says you can start and then, you know, get your approvals within 3 years. I don't think that is going to work. And the reason why it's not going to work is within that 3 year, this bureaucrat always will find something somewhere, and then you're going to be at their ransom. So we need to look at a clear model by which all approvals come in 30 to 45 days, all approvals. And once approved, then they can't go back on it. Then if there is a deviation, that person who gave the approval becomes responsible for. So I would say broadly, these are the areas which I thought I should cover as part of my reaction to both the presentations earlier today. Thank you very much.